The most fearsome predator of the Jurassic is watching his prey. Peering through the water, the carnivore fixes on his unwary victim, waiting for the perfect moment to strike. Under these azure waters lies the future continent of Europe. But now, in the late Jurassic period, all that exists here are a few scattered islands. The breakup of the old continents has pushed up the ocean floor and raised sea levels, flooding the lowlands and creating vast, shallow seas. Here, dinosaurs do not rule. Instead, giant marine reptiles have evolved, perfectly adapted to life in these beautiful waters. All of them are air breathers, like this 8-ton Cryptoclitus. On the land, they are cumbersome hulks. But in the water, they are transformed. All sea reptiles once lived on land. But 75 million years ago, the ancestors of these creatures took to the water, and their legs became graceful flippers. They share this shallow sea with other strange Jurassic creatures, like the ammonites that ride the currents, snaring small prey with their tentacles. These rich, sunlit waters are on the northern edge of the ancient Tethys Ocean, the sea that separates the Earth's two continents, one in the north and one in the south. Once a year, they are the stage for a remarkable natural drama. It starts with a single pregnant Opthalmosaurus, followed by hundreds more of her kind. All are gathering here from deeper water to give birth. These are the oldest of marine reptiles and most completely adapted to aquatic life, with streamlined, fish-like bodies. Most other marine reptiles, like Cryptoclitus, use all four flippers to chase the blizzards of fish through the water. Flapping like underwater wings, these flippers can be used separately to give them enormous maneuverability, or together for sudden bursts of speed. This unique method of locomotion is destined to disappear from the ocean at the end of the age of the dinosaurs.